Hello and welcome. Thanks for joining us. We're going to be treated to a gorgeous day for baseball on the show. It's the Milwaukee Brewers going up against the Atlanta Braves. First pitch coming your way next. All right, ready to get underway. Here's the veteran second baseman, Colton Wong. And a 2-1 on the way. And a foul ball. The wide to kick the pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And there's one down. Exactly. Willie Adames stands in. Next offering is in for a strike. Nice warm day here. Good baseball weather. Does that change anything, Chris, especially for the hitters?
Absolutely. You feel so much more comfortable at the plate. You're not worried about, you know, getting jammed on fastballs inside part of the plate. You can kind of be more selective instead of just looking out away so that you can get the barrel to it. And that part, you can get on the inside part of the plate as well.
Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. One down, base is empty. And a foul ball, he stays alive.
See how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Wanted to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
And now it's Christian Yelich. Left-hand batter waits. And 1-2. Got it. Strikes out the side to begin the game. What a start. Bottom of the first. So now to the plate for Atlanta, Eddie Rosario. And he deals. Ball. That misses. And the count's full.
Count is full. Three balls, two strikes.
The pitch. Swing and a broken bat flare. And he'll be safe at first.
Anything but pretty right there, but he'll take it every time. Not much the defense can do there. They're playing the odds that he'll pull it right at him, but a little slow roller the other way is pretty much indefensible.
Got him looking. And one out now. Matt Olson digs in now. This guy has turned into a beast. Pitch misses there. Ball two.
2-1. He's going.
Rosario runs. Hit hard but foul off to the left. Rosario stands at first with one out. Two two. And that just misses. Double play ball to second to Adames. That's one. On to Tellez, and the double play ends the inning. Top of the second, and now here's the veteran DH, Andrew McCutchen. 1-1 now. And he swings over the top there.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Next offering is way upstairs. And here it comes. Stays alive. Ground ball, left side. Sneaks through, base hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff knock.
Gotta love the resiliency he showed in that at bat, battling with two strikes. Just one of those seeing eye base hits through the infield. He just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those can find a hole and get you a knock.
Swing and a miss. next pitch is downstairs.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
The pitch. And a foul ball, he stays alive. No score here in the second. Cut on and miss, struck him out, and now one away. Now it's Hunter Renfro.
The right fielder, number 12, Hunter Renfro.
The 2-2.
Full count, three balls, two strikes.
The punch out there, back-to-back strikeouts. Omar Narvaez at the plate. There's a 1-1. There's a swing and a miss. At the belt and fires. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. We head to the bottom of the second. Now the Atlanta cleanup hitter, Marcelo Zuna. The 1-2. Renfro on the move to his left. He's got it. And there's one down. Here's Austin Riley.
The third baseman, Austin Riley.
Pitch misses inside, and it's a full count.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
He swings and fouls one off. Second inning here, no score. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Swing and a miss, struck him out. That's out number two. Two outs, base is empty. Adam Duvall at the plate. And the righty deals. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. And a ball evens the count.
Playing two balls, two strikes.
Righty to the plate. Stays alive. Righty delivers, and that skips in the dirt.
3-2.
Five foul balls in this at bat so far, and these guys are going head to head. You can see the crowd. They're starting to get into it a little bit more, even though there hasn't been a ball in play yet. When you go that deep into it at bat, the hitter usually comes out on top.
Dansby Swanson is going to get a chance to hit. Burns with a move to first. Duvall back on a dive. Duvall off of first with two away. Next one is off the play. And now 3-1. Right-hander kicks, deals. That's towards center. Kane gliding back, makes the grab, and that's the inning. Back here in Atlanta. Well, here we go, top of the third, scoreless game. And here's the veteran outfielder, Lorenzo Kane. Falling behind 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
The pitch. Line drive. That's a hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
Well, that was one of those high percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride and load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
The pitch. There's a strike at the knees. That is strike two.
That's a great take right there. Even though it's a strike, with the situation, runner on first base, you want to keep the ball off the ground. And you swing at that pitch, most likely you roll into a double play.
Kicks and fires. Just outside. Full count, 3-2. And a pitch. And there's a foul ball. That one is hammered right field. That's back. Pulls it in on the warning track. Colton Wong up to hit.
Up next from Milwaukee, the second baseman, Colton Wong.
The 1-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. And a pitch. And a swing and a miss. Picks up strikeout number 7. Willie Adames up now for the Brewers. Next offering is in for a strike. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. Little slider action.
The next pitch misses. 2-2.
Definitely a swing and miss slider down and in. He finished that really well. Just couldn't get him to offer at it.
Got him. That's his second strikeout. Back at Truist Park, there's Dickerson now. Swing and a miss. Now 1-2.
Talk about tying a guy up. That was ugly.
Stays alive. Kicks and deals. Chases that one out of the zone. Leadoff hitter gone in the third. And now it's Travis d'Arnaud at the plate. The pitch. Foul ball there. And he deals. And it's even up.
Playing two.
Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And there's two down. Here's Eddie Rosario. Reached on an infield single his first time. Rosario. 3-2. Now fly ball to right center. Kane makes the catch, and that'll do it. Here at the ballpark, here's Yelich at the dish. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Got him. And that's the first out. And now it's Andrew McCutchen, and he's already singled in this game. And now the lefty.
Love how vocal the umpire is today. No doubt in the hitter's mind, catcher's mind, and even the pitcher's mind as to the conviction in the call.
Makes the grab for the second out. Here's Rowdy Tellez.
Now batting the first baseman, Rowdy Tellez.
And that's ball four.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Hunter Renfro at the plate. That's ripped, and this one could be extra bases. Lead runner gets the stop sign at third. It's a two-out double, second and third now. So two aboard and two out, scoreless game. Up now for Milwaukee, Omar Narvaez. And it's fouled away. Next pitch, way upstairs. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Now, that sets up a really big at-bat in this game. These are the moments when everyone in the stadium gets really locked in.
And a pitch. And a swing and a miss.
Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't see a visit from the pitching coach here. Just to remind him, focus on the hitter. Don't worry about anything else.
And now 2-2. And fouled off. Tellez on third. Renfro at second. Narvaez at first. Two out of the inning. Hammered on the line. Base hit. One runs in. Two runs across now.
Gets the job done as he brings home a pair. He got a pitch he could drive, but he didn't get too excited like a lot of guys do and pull off the baseball. Really good timing all the way through the swing, and the barrel was so on plane with the ball. Easy drive into the gap for that double.
Two on, two outs. And a swing and a miss. Inning over, and it could have been worse. And welcome back. Bottom four, Ozzie Albies up to the plate. Here comes a pitch. Missed.
2-1.
The 2-1. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Left-hand batter waits, stays alive. Two-two now. And there's a fly ball deep right field. That one carrying. It bangs off the wall. And he's got a leadoff triple. And now Matt Olson up to hit. So now 1-2.
Well, here's a good opportunity in this inning to get on the scoreboard after that leadoff hit. And hardly order coming up right behind him. This is where they need to get going.
Left-hand hitter waits. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Runner at third here. Nobody out. Next offering is fouled back. The pitch stays alive.
Also really good at bat. What I like about this guy, his bat stays in the zone for a long time. Gives him the ability to foul off tough pitches.
And a 1-2 again. Olsen tries to check his swing. Now a look to third. No swing. Earl Hendricks with the call. And the right-hander deals. That one hammered, but pulled foul. The pitch. And a swing and a miss. One down. Here's Marcelo Zuna.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
Here's a 1-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Tying run at the plate. They say it went. On to first, and he's out.
Well, maybe approaching this at bat with a bit too much determination. Sometimes you just got to let the game come to you.
So up next, Austin Riley struck out swinging his first time. And a pitch. Fouls one off. 2-2.
Well, he knows they don't want to give him anything to hit, but when you've got opportunities to drive in runs, you've got to.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that'll do it. Welcome back. Ready now for the fifth inning. Now it's the second baseman, Colton Wong. The wind of the pitch. And a weak ground ball to the left side. Gets it to first. One up, one down. Next for Milwaukee, Willie Adames.
The shortstop, Willie Adames.
Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. Two outs, base is empty. Now it's Christian Yelich. The wind of the pitch. Rips one to right. That's a base hit. And that extends the inning. So, man aboard. Here's Andrew McCutchen to hit. Yelich goes. Pitch is low. Throw to second and great jump. That one misses, and a count is 3-1. Two outs. So now two on and two outs.
Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
And now it's Rowdy Tellez.
If he can get through this one, put up a zero, this will help in his outings to come.
And here it comes. Inside corner, and that's called a strike.
That front door slider is such a devastating pitch. You don't want to get beat by the inside fastball, so you cheat a little bit, and then by the time...
Swings and misses. That's the third out. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Here's the center fielder, Adam Duvall. Here's a 1-2. That one missed.
Playing two balls, two strikes.
And now it's filled up.
Expect for that guy to come right at you with a fastball, something in the zone, because he does not want to allow the leadoff walk.
Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. That one misses, so a leadoff walk.
Didn't miss by much right there. Just couldn't get the call off the inside corner.
Dansby Swanson stands in. Runner at first with no outs here. Burns with a move to first, and he's back standing. Righty delivers. Ground ball to first. Could be two. Takes it to the bag. That's one. Goes to second. Safe there. Alex Dickerson next up for the Braves. Went down on strikes his first time through. Man at second. And the 1-2 misses to even the count. At the belt and fires. Stays alive. Here's a 2-2. Ripped on a line. Yelich puts it away. And there's two away. Travis Darno next up for the Braves. Duvall on its second with two down. Next pitch downstairs. Two balls and a strike.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
That one in for a strike, 2-2.
Getting a little frustrated with the strike zone.
That one fouled off.
Oh, really laboring here in the fifth. Next pitch is going to be number 100. Man, you got to think, this is probably his last inning if he can get through this thing.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. Man on second, two down. Hard hit left side. And that one finds its way through. Now a long throw home. In there. He scores. And they trail by one.
Well, back within one as he brings home the run. Got the top of the ball a little bit, but not much. That was hit pretty hard through the infield. So I think he'll be happy with that swing. Definitely generated some good bat speed.
This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Telez brings it in, and the inning is over. Now here's Darren O'Day to take over for the Braves. Right-hander who throws from the side, really almost down under. And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, boo.
Here's the catcher, Omar Narvaez. Foul ball. Nobody out. Runner at first. Stays alive. Next offering is foul back. Righty to the plate. And a foul ball. He stays alive. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. And that's the first out. Now it's Lorenzo Cain. Singy, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. In the dirt. Now batting Michael Brasso. So how much does his speed factor into his ability to go get it?
It's heartbreaking for the hitter because off the bat, he thinks this ball is going to get down. Because of that speed and the ability to make up so much ground, he enters the...
Well, got to pause on that thought as that'll do it for the inning. The new pitcher in the game, Yandel Gustave.
Number 31. Stop it.
at Truist Park. Bottom of the sixth inning. Now in for the Braves, Ozzie Albies. And the righty deals.
There's one guy that I can think about, Boog, who started as a third baseman, Alex Gordon, and then became an elite perennial gold glover out in left field for the Kansas City Royals. But he's a guy, when you watch him play, you would imagine that that's all he ever played in his life was the outfield.
The first baseman, Matt
Olson. And the next pitch is way outside. Yeah, some guys just have instincts, right? I mean, that's the way it goes. We talk about Larry Walker, the Hall of Famer, and his instinct on the bases, despite the fact that he didn't play a ton of baseball as a kid. And a pitch. And that one pulled foul. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Right-hander kicks, deals, stays alive. The pitch. And a swing and a line drive at a right field and a base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Man, that feels so good when you can win a battle like that. Pull that one right in the direction of the shifted defense, but no one could make a play on it. I mean, that's his approach, and it's probably not changing.
And the batter now, Marcell Ozuna. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And now two gone. Now the third baseman, Austin Riley, who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts. Right-handed reliever. Squibbed out in front of the plate. Throw over to Tellez. Inning over. Back here in Atlanta, here's the third baseman, Michael Brasso. Swing and a miss, struck him out. And there's one away. Colton Wong up now for the Brewers. This is a guy you got to keep an eye on when he digs in. Definitely been known to drop a drag bunt from time to time, and he's pretty good at it, Chris.
Yeah, and he creates a sense of urgency for the defense because of the speed, because of the ability to put down that bunt.
And he hits a ground ball right side and foul ball. This one lifted in the air, left field. Ozuna under it. That's out number two. Willie Adames up now for the Brewers. And the pitch. That's inside. Two down, nobody on. Swing and a high fly ball left field. Ozuna makes the catch, and that'll do it. Back here at the ballpark, set for the last half of the seventh. And now the center fielder, Adam Duvall. Kicks and deals. Ripped, but it curls foul. Kicks and fires. And a foul ball, he stays alive.
Everyone here understands just how quickly things could change.
Next offering is downstairs. The pitch. Hard on the ground to first. And he handles it himself for the out. Dansby Swanson next up for the Braves.
Swanson, former first-round pick by the Arizona Diamondbacks. Vanderbilt player in college, College World Series player, all that good stuff, but really coming into his own.
Pitch misses, and the count is 3-1. The tying run at the plate, and he walked it.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
Brent Suter taking over on the mound. With a single base runner, because of all the power, they are dangerous to tie this thing up or take the lead.
Walks out of the bullpen can absolutely kill your momentum. Very quickly, they're in some hot water trying to protect this lead.
Swanson at first, one gone. Next pitch misses. Now two balls and a strike. And he deals. Pulled hard, but it's a foul ball.
He's gone off speed. He needs to elevate here with two strikes out of the zone.
And a 2-2. Stays alive. One run game, one out, one on. Next pitch just misses, and it's 3-2. And now the lefty, and ball four, two aboard.
Oh, looking for a swing and miss right there, or for the ump to help him out and make the call with that last pitch, but neither happened. Close pitch, but a good take to earn that walk.
So the tying run at second. Grounded to third, could be two. Tags the runner for one. Double play. They can't seem to break through. Inning over. Tyler Matzik will take over on the mound. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Number 68. At the top of the eighth, now the left fielder, Christian Yelich.
Well, you get to this part of the order. Yeah, there's some pop there, but more likely there's some base hits. So very important to be patient. Let the pitcher walk you, if he will.
Next offering clips the zone count even at two. And a ground ball to first, and that's just foul. The 2-2. And now the count filled up 3-2.
Three balls, two strikes, full count.
3-2 now. And down on strikes. Leadoff man is out here in the eighth. Now, Andrew McCutchen. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite-level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. Fouled off. He was late. And a pitch. And now the count is even. Here comes a pitch. And downstairs.
Well, he's not afraid to fall into a two-strike count. Knows the strike zone very well, so much so that I think umpires will look at him and determine whether it's a ball or strike, if he swings or not.
Ozuna settles under it and makes the catch. And there's two down.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
And that one fouled off. The punch out there. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Ready for the bottom of the eighth. Now the leadoff spot for the Braves, Eddie Rosario. The 2-1. And a strike in there. Next pitch misses inside. Ball three.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. A wind in the pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive.
Hanging in there pretty good against the lefty.
That's ripped to right down the line. Renfro makes the play, and there's one down.
Man, that's so frustrating. You hit the ball hard. You understand the situation. You want to get on base and try to score that tying run, but no reward right there, and just going to have to sit on it.
So Brad Boxberger rolls into the game. He's being eased into the game here with the bases empty. And next for Atlanta, Ozzie Albies, known for his late inning heroics. And the right-hander deals. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And there's two away. Here's Matt Olson.
The first baseman, Matt Olson.
The pitch. And that one wrapped foul. Stays alive. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Swing and a miss, and that is that. So Luke Jackson gets the call. It's his job to keep his team in the game.
Number 77, Luke Jackson.
We go to the ninth. Now it's Hunter Renfro. Next pitch inside, and it's 2-1. Swings through that one for strike two.
For this guy, it's truly a battle when he steps into the box. Only one thing on his mind, seeing that pitch out of the hand and hit it hard somewhere.
And down on strikes he goes. Now one gone in the ninth. Here's the catcher to hit, Omar Narvaez. A strikeout and a walk. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, that's really the money spot. Down and away, if you can locate that consistently, it's going to be real.
Oh, that pitch got away from him, and that's a hit by pitch. He had two strikes on him. And he hit him.
I think he's getting hit whether he tries to get out of the way or not. That just seemed to be tracking him out of the pitcher's hand.
The pitch. And a count 1-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Now two out. Michael Brasso up now for the Brewers.
The third baseman, Michael Brasso.
Hey, 2-1 pitch is in there, and the count is even. On the ground, into the outfield, base hit. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch, just shot it through the infield.
Colton Wong getting ready to hit. Bounce to the right. He'll do it himself, and that is that. So Josh Hader gets the call of the mound. Welcome back. Here's the left fielder, Marcell Ozuna.
Oh, an interesting situation. One swing, you can tie up the ball game. But if you're patient and work a walk, then you bring the game-winning run to the plate.
Next offering is fouled back. A swing and a miss. One away. So digging in, Austin Riley.
These home fans, they are making a lot of noise, putting pressure on that pitcher out there.
The pitch. This one in the air, center field. Way back there. And it's gone. Austin Riley goes deep, and they tie it up. It's 2-2. So up next, Adam Duvall. At the belt and fires. And there's ball four. How big a deal is that walk?
I don't think it's a big deal, because if you pitch to the previous hitter with the power he has, he can hit a home run. I think it was a calculated walk. We'll see how it pays off here.
Kicks and deals. Slice down the right side. One down. Winning run on at first. Chopped on the ground. And Swanson is set down. Now it's Alex Dickerson.
Oh, how he'd love to walk it off right here.
Left-hand hitter waits. Comes up empty. That's strike two.
Just amazing to me how many closers and back-end relievers just throw absolute gas these days. I never would have had a chance.
Bounced up the middle. Adames collects in plenty of time to first. They limit the damage here. And welcome back. On to extra innings. Up now for Milwaukee, Willie Adames. Gonna count one and two.
Well, it's kind of deflating. You blow that lead in the bottom of the ninth. So here's a new opportunity. Hit the reset button. Try to get some more runs and then close it out in the bottom half of this one.
Line drive, base hit. And they get it in quickly. First and third now with nobody out.
I'm sure that feels pretty good after going hitless in this one so far. Hooked around that pitch on the outside, but he was still able to square it up pretty nicely. And that takes quick, strong wrist to pull that off.
And now, Christian Yelich. Tried to check his swing. Appeal to third. Yes, he did. Down he goes on strikes. Two on, one out. Now the Brewers cleanup hitter, Andrew McCutchen. Trying to keep this a 2-2 game. And here in extra innings. Not close with that one. 2-1.
Tough spot right here. A couple runners on. Two ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
two on, one out. And that's down and away.
They tried to get him to go. Chase the pitch down and away, but he wouldn't bite.
And here's a 3-2. Rolled to short, possible two ball. Slings to second, on to Olson. That's two. Back here in extras, and a new pitcher on the mound at the bottom half of the inning, Aaron Ashby. Keston Hira comes on defensively now as he takes over as the new second baseman.
Number 18.
Back at Truist Park, on to the bottom of the 10th. And here's the catcher, Travis Darno. And a 1-1. Right side. And there's a hit. And the leadoff man aboard. Throw comes in, and the winning run stops 90 feet from home. Nobody out. Back to the leadoff spot in the Braves lineup. Now it's the right fielder, Eddie Rosario. The lefty ready, and a 1-1. And that one just missed off the outside edge.
In the infield at the corners, don't be surprised to see them come home first and prevent that run from scoring.
Nobody out. The winning run 90 feet away. And here it comes. Rosario swings and drives one deep to right field. Out of here. And that ends the game. Wow. He'll circle the bases and the Braves walk it off in extra innings.
Fourth ball game, you get to extra innings, it seems like every guy is trying to come up with the big swing to hit the homer and end the ball game. Well, he did it. Huge swing of the bat, and we're all headed home.
Your final score 5-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shambi. We'll see you soon.
The victorious Atlanta Braves, 5-1, 7 hits, no errors. They left 8 men on base. For the Brewers, 2 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 11 men on base.